Take a good long look. See the wrath of the Golden Order, the Order's justice writ in blood. This is what's become of your precious witch. Naught but expired meat and bone. This is a proper death, O Prince. Look at this rotten hole. No more children can be got from this useless flesh. Behold. Your mother is dead. This is revenge, you witch. And you, you ghoul. This is the wrath of Dee.
Ah, hello. The rotten witch is dead. The Golden Order unsullied. Now I can look my brother Darien in the eye. Honeyed rays of gold, deliver my spirit. Darien, now I have no regrets. Honeyed rays of... Darien, honeyed...
Thank you. you are wise, you my flesh. If you are wise, my flesh, right. If you are wise, my flesh, right.
a pleasure to see you. A pleasure indeed. I am Gari, a great sage. In my day, anyway. I'd hoped to ask a favor when one of your ilk came along. A strapping young tarnished, able to cross the Scarlet Swamp of Aeonia. Don't fret, I'll provide fine recompense. Should you accept, I will teach you the secret of Celia, the town you see there. Ah, then you are willing to lend a hand, are you? I need your help to heal a certain young girl. Her name is Millicent. You will find her beyond Celia, resting at the church atop the cliff, stricken by the rotting sickness. Oh, as promised. Go on. Now let me have... Well, well, the work of a true artisan. A meticulous, bold craftsman. Can you give me some time? As well made as it is, it won't be much. Can you give me... As well made.
Is repaired.
It will forestall the rotting sickness, I'm sure. Will you give it to the girl?
I will reward you in kind.
Millicent rests at the church, tended to by the witless place. Worship her with her rotting sickness. Wretched fate. Do you find the ground show such concern? The Outbinder found her. A mere babe in the swamp of Aeonia. She is But the rotting sickness erodes one's memory.
I doubt that she remembers the first thing.
Oh, I must be getting old.
Now, all you need...
She's convalescing in the church.
Do so. Now, she's come.
Do so.
You are wise, my flesh. You ask that I stab myself with the needle to quell the scarlet rot. But how? Never mind. I've decided I would rather trust you than simply continue to spoil from within. Would you mind averting your eyes for a moment? Well, that was easier than expected. But why do I feel so... I hoped to see you again. My apologies for when last we met. I fainted before I could even thank you. Everything is as you said. Even the nightmares have abated. And now, though I can scarcely believe it myself, I can move as I please. Not that I could ever truly repay you, but I would like you to have this. By way of thanks. A token, though it is. I'm considering, with the needle buried in my flesh, I've started to recall my destiny. It's all thanks. My name is Millicent. I'm considering, with the needle, my destiny. I'm considering, with the needle, my destiny. This place felt familiar to me, so I decided to pay a visit, hoping to find someone here, but I've only found emptiness. Perhaps before my departure, I needed someone to say farewell to. Well, I must focus on my journey, for which I have you to thank. I must stay strong. Well, I must folk, I must...
thank you kindly for giving the needle to Millicent. Now she too can begin her journey and stare her fate straight in the eye. You've been a saint through and through. As thanks, I vow to impart to you my knowledge of the lost sorceries of the Cellians, descendants of the Eternal. Oh, you noticed, did you? Indeed, Millicent did visit this hovel of a home. It seems the memories eaten away by the rotting sickness yet remain, but faintly. However, she has no need of me anymore. No, she must embark on her journey and stare her fate in the eye. I mustn't impede. As I've aged, I've found the best way to aid the young is to be forgotten.
Again. In truth, it's been smooth sailing for me. The Scarlet Rot has stilled since last we met. As such, I've been able to continue my journey. Though rather vexingly, I realized that if I still had my sword arm, I could have aided you in battle. Are you giving me this arm? Thank you. I am in your debt yet again, I think. If the arm serves well enough, it might be possible for me to wield a sword again. Yet again, the arm you gave me truly is a thing of wonder. It feels just like my own, even handling a sword. Perhaps it is foolish to say this to you of all people, but I am sure of my skill with the sword. Thus, I would have you call upon me in battle, should you ever have the need. It is the only way that I can express my thanks. Think we'd meet in such a place. What could your purpose possibly? No. I know well enough who you are. And what I know is good enough for me. Call upon me again in battle, should you have the need. I'm searching for a fort to the north of the ruins. I heard the master of the fort was given a medallion that allowed him to visit the Halig Tree. Indeed, I believe that is where Melania will be found. The Halig Tree is hidden somewhere in these northern lands. I'm searching for a fort. again we meet, I can only surmise our purposes are aligned. In which case, allow me to explain myself. I am of Melania's blood, but in what capacity, I know not. I could be sister, daughter, or an offshoot. Whatever the case, though, I am certain of a kinship between us. There is something I must return to Melania. The will that was once her own. The dignity. The sense of self. That allowed her to resist the call of the Scarlet Rot. The pride she abandoned. To meet Radahn's measure. There is something of the will that was the dignity. There is something the will, the dignity.
Thank you. I see. Oh, so it wasn't just me this happened to. To think he'd forget who you were as well. I knew he'd burn himself out. Old Hugh. I think we could talk him into leaving the Round Table Hold now. But maybe it's better that we don't. It's only proper that we respect his choice to stay. I'll remain with Hugh. He made me who I am today. I'd like to return the kindness, in whatever small way I can. Please, become Elden Lord. Hugh was always saying that you were a lord to him. So slay her with the weapons he smithed. Slay the god Marika, who cursed us all. I see. I see.